excited about this show. Today we're offering you an A to Z guide on how to
the back porch or sit on the step and look up at the sky.
Yep. Yeah. You know what? What you said was so important, that creativity and being yourself is so important, because people so often...
Well, see, I like your book. I like the 1001 ways, because thumbing through them, when you hit something that really reminds you of yourself, you say, oh, I thought of that.
That's right. Absolutely. Yeah. You know, number 683, run a bubble bath. Number 221, you know, dance at home.
I like number 584. I think it was when you're out, number 584. You know, when you're out at a party, just whisper quietly to your spouse, I'm so glad I married you.
That's right.
Isn't that good? You're the best.
That's right.
Oh, honey, gives me goosebumps just
thinking
about it.
Yeah. Married people forget to flirt with their own spouses. You know, it's so important to keep that alive. And it's crazy little things like, have you ever written I love you on the bathroom mirror with a piece of soap? Or, now it's summer, take some chalk and write it, you know, on the driveway in huge letters.
On the driveway, so when he comes home, he says, what the hell are you doing on the driveway? Some gift ideas, Greg.
Oh, well, first of all, a tip for the guys, never give women practical gifts. Okay?
Yeah.
No toasters, no blenders.
No ironing boards,
like that.
No, really, please.
But for you ladies, don't forget that guys do like practical things. You can buy us a power saw, things like that. It's absolutely fine. Now, do you know what the difference between a gift and a present is?
No.
A gift is something that you want, and a present is something that I want you to have. So, for instance, if your favorite perfume is Chanel No. 5, I give it to you, that's a gift, guaranteed to please you. But when a man gives a woman lingerie, guess what?
What?
90% of the time, it's for him, it's a present. Now, one is not better or worse than the other, but it's important to notice that difference so that we know that we are, see, a present is expressing myself, maybe my creativity. Whereas a gift is something just for you.
Well, I will tell you this. I gave Stepman a great gift the other day. I thought it was both a present and a gift, because he was talking about this golf bag that he had seen, and it was a pretty expensive golf bag, and he was saying that I should give it to somebody else. One of the guys who works in my company, he was saying that he would really appreciate that because he plays golf a lot, and it's the best golf bag ever, so I'll get best golf bag. And I called the store that day, and I had that golf bag sent over, filled to the top with golf balls, because, you know, golfers love golf balls. I thought he was going to weep over this golf bag. He stood in the middle of the night. He's standing there staring. He goes... Next morning, he goes, did you see my golf bag? Did you see my golf bag? Really, one of the best golf bag gifts I've ever seen, really.
And one of the great points about this is that you acted immediately.
Yeah, because you know what I was thinking? I was thinking, well, should I wait till Christmas? And Christmas is 6 months away.
Should I
wait till his birthday?
No.
That's 9 months away. I'm telling you.
That's right.
It worked wonders, let me tell you.
Valentine's Day is not the most romantic day of the year. It's what I call an obligatory romance day. There's obligatory romance and there's optional romance. You see, if you are... Here's what's really romantic. Coming home on a Tuesday night with a bottle of champagne. Or filling her car with balloons. Or hiding little notes all over the place. Those little things are what romance is really all about. Romance is a bridge between men and women. If we didn't have this, we would be standing on opposite sides, yelling and screaming at each other. See, romance is communication. That's what it is. Every single thing, from the salad shooter, it was his attempt to communicate with her, to the photo. You see, these things take the place of saying literally, I love you. They do this, they keep the romance in the day-to-day. They don't wait for Valentine's Day, Christmas, birthdays, anniversaries. If you do this, just incorporate it as a part of your life. Instead of waiting for some other time, then you will keep that spark alive. I've seen hundreds of people like that. And, you know, it's not a big secret, but it's just taking that action and not waiting. Women say they want more romance. They're not nagging. And this is one of the things that works so well in the class, that guys are talking to me, not just another woman. You see, what happens here is that when a woman says she wants romance and you interpret it as nagging, you stop listening. A guy simply stops listening to a woman when she thinks it's nagging. It's a real need that people have, not just women. See, guys need romance in their life, but we tend to talk about it differently. We want the emotions expressed in different ways.
The gospel according to Godek. Valentine's Day is not the most romantic day of the year.
No, it's
what?
Not.
For instance, Michael will, I'll come in one day and he'll have gotten the Scrabble game out and spelt love you babe or something when I come home, you know, and something like that is just, is very small.
My next guest says there's still hope. He says there's a little Valentino in all you guys out there. He's written a book called 1001 Ways to Be Romantic. Meet Greg Godek. Welcome, Greg.
Hi.
Give us a couple of rules for
Well, the number one rule of romance is that you need to keep your relationship as the number one priority in your life. Too many men put their work, their golf, other things like that. You've got to keep the relationship first. Second rule is that relationships are not 50-50. They're 100-100.
Scare me for a second.
You have to be giving 100% of yourself 100% of the time as a goal. Now we know that...
Hi, Greg. God, there's a lot happening here.
Oh, this is wonderful. I usually am around people who are unromantic because I teach classes and I've written these books on how to be more romantic. So this is very inspiring. This is just wonderful.
Yeah, you know, we love this because we were talking backstage about how on Valentine's Day, we all sort of share this common bond. Everybody feels romantic. Everyone wants to do something for the person they love to show them how much they love them.
Mm-hmm.
And we all come up with ways to be sexier, to be innovative, to be creative. But your book tells us how to do that all year round.
Oh, that's right. You know, I believe that Valentine's Day is not the most romantic day of the year. Because, you see, Valentine's Day is an obligatory romance day. You have to be romantic. I think it's a law. You know, if you don't send flowers or candy or something, don't show up at home tonight. You know, you're in big trouble. But the real romance is when you make the gesture when you don't have to, when you're not forced to, when you come home on a Tuesday night with a bottle of champagne just to say, let's celebrate. Celebrate what? Us. You know, or fill her car with balloons, or put a rose under the windshield wiper of her car, or run a bubble bath. You know, those things are romantic. Romance is about the simple things, the everyday things. It's not just about furs and diamonds and expensive vacations and things like that. And you know, a lot of times when a woman says to a guy, I want you to be more romantic, what he hears in his mind is, I want you to be different from who you are. I want you to spend a lot of money. And it's just not true from what everyone has said and the folks in the audience. People want the little things, the truth. They want a part of you. And sharing yourself with your lover is just the best thing you could possibly do.